And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play Full Throttle. I actually figured out how to, defeat those people. So, as it turns out, I was just lacking a few items. For instance, this Cavefish guy, you need wooden beam in order to get his goggles. And the wooden beam you get from one of the guys, which I mistook. Okay, that's the guy who has the rocket booster.
What's wrong? Let die.
And
that should have a couple of good boosts left in it.
Okay, yeah. And actually, in order to defeat the vulture guy, you have to use the chain. The game does not give you any indication that you have to do that. In fact, it said the old guy told us that. Timing is important, which is sort of a false lead, but we have to use the chain. And okay, that's not the guy who has the wooden beam. Okay, so the guy who has the wooden beam also, yeah, we can't defeat we can defeat them right now. We can defeat the Cavefish guy, but the problem is that in order to get his goggles you need to have the wooden beam first, and the wooden beam you get from one of the three guys, I think, who pretty much all look alike, in which I'm stuck for one another, but which are in fact different enemies. Okay, that's not the one. By the way, this
aggressive little wart, ain't ya?
This guy not just looks like the black guy from the Polecats we saw in the cutscenes earlier, but also has the voice by the same person. Okay, that's the guy who has the wooden beam.
Now I'm mad.
No, it's not. Okay.
Eat this. You're gonna die.
And it does this annoying thing that it switches the weapons.
I hate Polecats.
It sometimes switches the weapons automatically. Yeah. I hate this section. Okay, that was not the guy with the wooden beam. I think she has a chainsaw. I think that's the guy. No, not sure. So, yeah. That was in fact the guy. Okay. As I already mentioned, these enemies sort of look alike. At least those three. The guy with the wooden beam. The guy with the morning star. I think it's. I'm not sure what it's called that in English. Okay. And the guy. Yeah, so those three guys. Anyway, so now we have the wooden beam, and we can now get the goggles. But unfortunately, we have to first deal with these with a sufficient number of enemies until the guy with the Cavefish guy reappears. By the way, the vulture guy only appears one time. If you have defeated. If you defeat him, then he won't reappear. Or those other guys will. They will reappear. Yeah, I don't think that this is. I don't think that. This is a terribly good. Yeah. This part of the game is the best part of it, okay. Yeah, so now we got the goggles, we got the booster, and we got the hover device. Now we can technically, we can cross Hoya Hoya Gorge, but, no, wait, we can't because we don't have the ramp. So we need to find the hidden entrance of the Cavefish. might not be actually here. It's probably on the highway somewhere. So we shall take the next exit. Oh. You can actually not use the goggles while you're on the highway. Wait. Can we... Did you see that car? There. That was not the car that... That was not the crash site that we saw earlier. That was actually a different car. So I'm kind of curious whether that is just a glitch or whether there's something interesting going on. Let us go back. Let us go back and check out what's up with this car. Should be the next stop. Okay, let's stop. Okay, that's that car. But the car we saw a moment ago that was white. It was Rutger's car. No, I think this... Yeah, I think this was just... They made a mistake here. Showing the wrong car. Yes, okay. That was just a mistake. The art design. Okay. We need to be on my road. Sorry. And we need to look for this secret entrance. Oh. I think I saw something on the right there. But it was gone too quickly. And actually, I don't have mouse control. Okay. Okay. Now we're in the secret cave of the Cavefish. We need to find the ramp, which sort of brings up the question. How do you actually steal a ramp? Let us install, in fact, the hover device.
Looks okay for an aftermarket part.
And let us move on. This looks like a force field of some kind.
Everything about these guys is creepy.
Can we just take the ramp? Can actually. That's weird.
Everything about these guys is creepy.
I wonder whether we have actually have gone into the fortress, but I suppose not. So let us just leave then. How convenient that this ramp actually has a thing to attach it to a bike. We could say that this is lazy writing, but maybe that's just... Oh, I think we're being chased. Am I supposed to do something here?
Where'd he go?
And who was he?
My brothers, we have been visited by a spirit. The spirit of Ricky Myran, come to reclaim his ram.
Why did he get here?
He can't use it because he is a spirit. He is only expressing his anger, which we must honor. Oh, angry spirit of Ricky Myran, we honor your rage. But for now, the ramp must go back.
Okay, I think this is a little bit more complicated than just going there and taking the ramp. Could go there on foot, but that's probably not. There's no reason to do so, actually. So let's use our bike. Is there something, some item that we can grab here? No, there's not. Yeah. By the way, let's check our inventory.
This stuff reeks.
Okay, we still have some of this fertilizer left over.
This chain could never handle my horsepower.
We have a chainsaw.
It's that chainsaw I picked up on the mine road.
We have a wooden beam.
Incredible the kind of weapons you find out in the... Definitely not my style.
And one of those goggles. Okay. I wonder what happens if we just drive over there. Oh, can't exact, I think. Yes. So we have to walk there, apparently.
I think I'm getting in there.
So we sabotage it?
I should save something that potent for the mine road.
Okay, there's this fortress. Can we talk to it?
I'm not putting my lips on that.
Can we kick it?
Don't think I'm getting in there.
Okay, when we'll come back, folks, we shall try, to solve this puzzle, and get over Hoya Hogger Gorge. So, until next time, folks, until then.